Hey guys, this is Ashwini and welcome back. From this video, we are starting our Git series, and in this video, we will cover each and every point related to Git, how Git is working and why we are using Git, and practical and theoretical concepts. Each and everything we will complete in this series. So without waste time, let me start this video. So if you go on the internet and search what is a Git, okay, you will end up with this definition. This is a pretty common definition. I am pretty sure if you search like what is a Git, you will find this definition on the internet. Tons of definition are there, but this is a pretty common definition which we are like found on our internet. So when I was learning Git, I will also end up with this definition, but that time I haven't understand anything from this definition, okay? Because you will understand the definition after completing a Git, or when you work on a Git like for a year, then you will understand this definition, okay? So this definition consists of 3 points, that is open source, distributed, version control. Okay, open source might be you have an idea, something of free, okay, you can contribute that in that, okay, and distributed, and second is version control. So I want you to just keep these things like aside for 2 minutes. After that we will talk about each and everything in it, okay, distributed and version control. So first let me make some story to make you understand how Git is working and what is the architecture of a Git. Okay, so if you want to make a communicate between two programs, like this is your P1, this is your P1, and this is your P2, okay, and I want to say your P1 communicate to P2 sending a request and P2 sending a response, like this. So you can say this is client, right, and this is server, right? And if I give you example, if you are a Java developer, right? So we have Postman, right? And in other side, we are having our server, means Spring Boot application, right? Spring application. So you can communicate this one. So as in same architecture, client server architecture, we are following when we want to communicate our program 1 to program 2. Actually, if you want to communicate any program, you are following this architecture. Your computer or your laptops are dummy devices. They are not making any communication with each other. Your programs make a communication. Okay? So these things will also apply on a Git. So if we talk about a Git also work in this manner. So if we talk about Git also have two things, that is client. And second, that is server. So if you have idea, or might be, I'm pretty sure you have listened about this thing, GitHub, Bitbucket, right? Bitbucket, these three things you have listened about. I know you have an idea about this, okay? So let's suppose this is your GitHub website, okay? This is your GitHub website. You will create account, right, and you will make a repo, and in your system this is your laptop, okay, this is your laptop and this is you, and you will install here Git, right? You will install Git. As I can show you, if I have installed Git and I will go to my documents and I will say okay, you can see here, right, GUI and bash. So when you install Git, each and every year in your directory you will find this signs like Git bash and Git GUI, right? So how this communication happens, like you install Git and you will pass and you will tell to your Git software like Git client, I need to communicate to particular address. You will pass address here. And what is the address? That address will be your repo address, and where your repo is in GitHub. Now I think now communication is clear, like how we are making a communication. But the thing is, how this thing is working? Okay, Ashwini, I got it. I installed software and I have set that URL or that origin in my Git software or Git client. Okay, you need to communicate there. If I comment something, if I push something, you need to put there, right? In my most of the videos I have mention a link of GitHub repository. Okay, you can in microservices video and each and every video, you can go there and download the links or clone. So that's a GitHub repository, right? You go there and clone it, and or either you can download it. So how you are downloading and how the cloning things is working. So now let me give you the overall architecture, how this things works in your system. Okay, so GitHub and Bitbucket, all these are different vendors which introduce their GitHub server. So they have one central repository, or we can say central server. There they install a GitHub server. Okay, let's suppose they have server, this one big server they have. Okay, this is a server of GitHub. Which server? This is a server of GitHub. Okay, and they have installed here, they have installed what? They have installed Git server. Now if any request will came from Git client and Git server is capable enough to hold that request, right? Like I am talking to you and you are talking to me. In that same way, that example we have seen here, like client service architecture, right? So in this way, what we need? We need server, we need client. So what I told you, GitHub have one central server, or their server. There they have installed Git server. Okay, understand that they have pretty big server. Okay, and Git is a software. We can say Git server is a different software. Okay, and they have their server. On top of their server, they have installed Git server. Now we need a Git client to communicate that particular Git server. And how we can communicate? To make our repository there on their website and give a passing their URL. Now understand, right? We are communicating through client and server. Now I want to take you to the your real-time environment. Okay, so this is your company project. Okay, you are working in your company. This is in your GitLab or GitHub or Bitbucket, any service which your company is using. Okay, and they told you, okay, they are providing you the credentials. Through that you can log into the GitLab, or you can clone your software and try just doing your stories or in your development there, right? So let's suppose this is you and this is your laptop or computer, and this is your friend or your colleague, and he has his laptop. So what is it? This is laptop. Okay, yeah, now understand this architecture very peacefully. You will understand each and everything. Okay, so relax and let's see how this architecture is working. So if we talk about now, hey Ashwini, we join new team. This is a new developer. Okay, these guys are new developer. So this is my developer 1, dev 1, and this is my dev 2. Okay, now you are a team lead. This person is a team lead. Okay, now he told, okay, I have provided you access. Okay, now you can go to that URL and you can clone it. This is in GitHub Git server. This is Git server, and he will give you one URL. He will give one URL, and what URL it is? It is a GitHub repository URL. What URL it is? Let me change the color. That is GitHub repo. That is repo URL. Okay, now what do you need to do for making that your project clone or copy? If I told you, okay, just go to my system and copy that, what you will do? You will go to my system, put a pen drive and put that thing in your PD, in a pen drive, right? So that is same thing. You need a Git client. You need Git client in your system. With the help of Git client, it will give you the one GUI or window that is called Git Bash. Okay. Now, what you will type here? Git clone and that URL and the copy in your Git server. You have repo. Under repo, you have your project directories. Project that is called, you have a project directory, right? And this is a already working copy, or you can say a master, okay, a golden copy, which you are not allowed to change. So what you will do, you will clone that. Okay, what now you will do, or either you can make any other branch. We will talk about that advanced concept later. So we'll say okay, clone. He will also say clone. Okay, now you have that separate copy. This is your copy of that working directory or working project. This is your project. Now you have that project which available on Git server, GitLab, GitHub, wherever. Okay, you have that copy in your directory. You have that copy. Now what is this? Is this copy is the same repo? This is the same repo which available on a GitHub? No, this is not a same repo. This developer 2 have different repo. This is repo for developer 1, developer 2, and this is a repo for developer 1. Why I'm saying here might be confusing. Like here, Shri, you are saying the project is coming, now the repo is coming. What do you want to say? Okay, when you are cloning something from your server, or you when you push this command git clone, the git is an intelligent software or version control system that we'll talk about later. I'm not going to take that name, that's why I'm explaining you in a simple terms. Okay, so when you say clone or when you copy something, okay, that clone means, just in a layman terms, clone equals to copy. Okay, we are understanding like this. When we develop our concept, then we will talk about in actual technical terms clone and whatever terms we will use. So when you do clone, one local repo for your project will be created. Okay, and who create that repo? Git client will create that repo for you, and you are a developer one, right? So you have your repo that we call local repo. So if you make any changes, either write or either you can say override, okay, or either say update anything, those changes will not reflect back to your server. Why? Because if this Git will allow or your team will allow to make your changes, right, and you are a new person, you will make destroyed all the project at a time, right? So that's why if you make any changes, write, update or whatever you want to do in your local repo, it will only reflect to your working directory, or you can say in your workspace, that is a local workspace. Now let's suppose you have completed your work. Okay, now you want to push your changes there. So what you will do, you will directly say, okay, I want to push my changes. You will go and you will say push, right? And you have couple of files here, you will push that. Now developer 2 also working somewhere, okay, in some couple of files, and he also might be want to change up something. So before pushing something, okay, you need to add those file which you have changes, okay, and those file will be first go to the stage, and after that go to the local repo, and when you commit that file, right, go to the repo, and when you push that file, it will go to the actual server wherever you have mentioned that link. Okay, you have to mention that communication link between your client and server, that we will talk about later. Okay, how we will do that. Okay, so what is your version control? First I want to make these things clear. This man complete the work and he says okay, git add all files, dot means all files. After add, he say git commit hyphen m for message, and it is say like first commit like this, and after that he say like git push. Okay, so whatever the command with the information you are making, you have each and every log for your command, and inside your local repo, okay, you have copy of your modified file, or you can say revision of your modified file, and it should be tracked by a git client. Got it? Because it is in your local repo. So that's called version control system. When you make any single commit, it will create a different version for that, okay, and that version should go inside your server. So whenever someone want to commit their changes, this will say, okay, you are not up to date because this person has already pushed some changes, you need to take that. So we will say here, okay, pull, give me that changes. If any merge will come, we will talk about the merge or merge complete later. So you need to up to date your branch or your workspace. After that you can commit, and if you commit again, the version control will change, the version is changed. So each and every commit, the version is changed. So let me make you now understand that. That's called version control. So what is a version? It's for each and every commit, okay, and distributed. For every developer we have local copy, because this is our central copy. If we talk about this one, we have one central copy, that is working copy. We are not allowed to directly access it, so we clone it, it become a local copy through a git client. So if we have 100 developers, so it will become the 100 developers of local copy, right? I have changed the color, so do not confuse that. So it will become a local copies for 100 of developers. So that's why we are saying it is a distributed and version control. I hope you get an idea like what is git is and why, like open source it is simple, right? And what is distributed, it what is the version control system. Okay, now for the downloading things and practical implementations, we will talk about in our next video. I will catch you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.